Ark has been kept by one person all these years, a caretaker.
So there's one person who stays with the Ark.
Exactly. This person dedicates all his life to be with the Ark until he dies, basically. He is the only person on the face of the earth allowed to see the Ark.
Can you see if we can possibly get a 3-minute conversation with him?
Anything. Hmm.
Basically, for safety and security reasons, the chance of talking to the caretaker is impossible. He doesn't talk to anyone. He's not allowed.
Myself and Emiliano, we're trying to give proof to the physical, tangible existence of the Ark of the Covenant, but clearly, there's no way for the two of us to get inside and see the Ark for ourselves. So I think you and I are gonna have to accept that we're at a dead end.
Well, not necessarily. In Ethiopia, there are over 50,000 churches. And every single church has at least one replica of the Ark of the Covenant. In my opinion, there are so many ways of keeping the Ark somewhere safe. Could be here, could be anywhere. Yeah. What if I were to tell you that many believe that this church here is where they want you to believe that the Ark is hiding, but there is actually a much more secure place in the middle of nowhere where very few people have ever looked?
I mean, it makes a lot of sense to me. Why not lead everybody to one place while you're hiding it somewhere else?
Using Ptolemy's map of the world, we're hot on the trail of the Ark of the Covenant in Ethiopia. After thinking we had zeroed in on it at a church in Aksum, we learned that it may be secretly kept at a location deep in the countryside of Ethiopia.
If you're gonna hide the Ark of the Covenant somewhere, I would think you'd want somewhere inaccessible.
We're headed 115 miles west of Aksum to a remote area in the mountains of Tigray, to one of the most isolated and untouched churches in the world that dates back to the 6th century.
I'm going to take you to a place and that cannot be reached out by local laymen.
What a perfect place to hide the Ark.
There is a church that was carved 1,500 years ago into the rocks. So once you get closer to the base of these rocks, that is the holy part. You take your shoes off and then you climb up. There are places where you literally have to climb the face of the rock.
You're saying if we climb up, there's an actual church carved into the rock?
There is a church that was carved 1,500 years ago.
In order to reach this church, we will need to climb 2,500 feet in the air across sheer cliffs and trek extremely unstable terrain.
Are you coming with us?
No. Off you go.
All right.
I'm staying here. Enjoy.
Yeah. We'll let you know what we find in the church in the sky.
Enjoy.
I mean, this is unbelievable to think that somewhere at the top of these cliffs, there could be a place that houses the Ark, and it's here, essentially, in the sky, in an ancient church, on a mountaintop. We might be on the precipice of finally locating the Ark.
Beauty before age.
We've got to get up to this church, but there's no path, no stairs, no rope. The only way to get up there is to climb.
This is where they set shoes off. Take your time.
Yeah. We're like hundreds of feet up, our hands are sweating, we're focused, but below us, there's this giant drop. If you let go, if you slip, if you fall, it's over. The only thing to do is to just keep going.
Oh, dude.
Look at this, human remains.
Oh, whoa.
Wow, isn't that crazy?
It's like a tomb.
Could these human remains be the bodies of former explorers attempting to locate the Ark of the Covenant at this cliffside church?
I've never seen anything like this.
I guess there's only one way to find out.
Keep on going up.
We've got to keep going. There's nothing else we can do at this point. The fact that they built the church thousands of feet up in the sky on the side of a cliff. I mean, there's got to be something there.
Imagine over 1,000 years of pilgrims doing this.
Yeah. We want to get to this church. We've just got to give it all we've got. Even though our energy levels are slowly draining, we're committed.
It comes up to a top here. Wow. That's gorgeous.
Whoa.
We're at the top of this cliff.
Look at that view, buddy.
Gorgeous. And there's just this beautiful expanse, as far as the eye can see.
What a place.
Unbelievable.
It's absolutely breathtaking, until you realize the most dangerous part of the journey is yet to come. All right, see you in a bit.
Taking the view, okay?
Okay. Separating us from the entrance to this church, there's essentially a narrow ledge off the side of this cliff with a 1,000-foot drop, one false step, and you're done. The only thing to do is to brave and just go for it.
Hello. Hello.
Salam.
Anali salam.
Welcome to our church.
May we come in?
Yes, please.
Please, thank you. Wow, what a place. Wow, this is incredible.
As you walk into this place, I mean, I've never seen anything like it. The walls are covered in these gorgeous illustrations. It smells like incense. I mean, this place is ancient, it's mystical. This would be the perfect place to hide the Ark.
We've traveled a long, long way to get here. We've been seeking the Ark of the Covenant.
We're seeing if the possibility that it might be here in this church.
And the Ark is not here.
Is there any chance he knows where the Ark is?
The Ark is somewhere hidden.
This place is completely isolated. It takes an impossible trek to make it here.
It would be a perfect place to hide the Ark, but based on everything we've learned, if the Ark isn't here, my gut says that it's hidden somewhere close.